how China is accelerating its bid for chip supremacy. What do you think is the most in-demand commodity in the world? There's a case to be made for oil, natural gas, gold, and even Bitcoin. However, have you ever considered silicon semiconductor microchips? These tiny devices have become the main focus of international superpowers like China and the US, who are looking to establish chip supremacy. So, what exactly is the importance of these microchips? Well, consider the fact that they're the basis of almost every piece of technology, from laptops to smartphones to even fridges and toasters. These silicon semiconductor microchips allow these devices to do what they do. Ever since their invention in 1961, silicon semiconductors have revolutionized computing and the world at large. The current generation exists on a nanoscale and is estimated to get as small as an atom in the future. This reduction in size means they can fit into very tiny spaces, allowing for the creation of the smallest and most powerful computers yet. Just imagine a device that could control the entire world's electricity supply fitting in the palm of your hand. Such could be possible with silicon semiconductor chip technology. The next question that needs answering is why these superpowers, particularly China, are so interested in silicon semiconductor chips all of a sudden? Well, the simplest answer to that question is that it's about power. You see, in all things, every country has its best interests at heart. This has manifested in the past in particularly violent ways with colonization and aggressive expansion. Although the world has come into a more diplomatic understanding of territorial boundaries, there's a new conquest looming on the horizon. Ever since the internet went online in the 1980s, our lives have little by little become more online-based. Cyberspace is quickly replacing the real world, and so much of our work, communication, and entertainment take place there. There has even been much talk of the Internet of Things, which is a reality where even the most basic tools and appliances like pens and hammers are connected to the internet. As such, it should be no mystery why technological conquest and control is the next agenda for countries like China, the United States, and Germany. Though the United States still maintains the title of the world's greatest economic superpower, China is hot on its heels. The Southeast Asian country's growth rate cannot be underestimated, as they have turned from an afterthought to the center of production and consumption. When it comes to the realm of silicon semiconductor chip production, though, China has been at the mercy of its rival, Taiwan. And given that the United States is a strong ally of Taiwan, the dependency has gotten even more sour. From the Chinese perspective, there is no way they can continue to rely on their rivals when it comes to a commodity as important as silicon superconductor microchips. Such dependency only means they can be cut off at the source, slowing down their economic growth rate and conquest of cyberspace. For this reason, China has been looking to establish itself as the premier silicon semiconductor chip producer in the world. Ahead, we discuss a couple of methods the country intends to accomplish this. One of the number of ways China can establish silicon microchip supremacy is by invasion and colonialism, particularly invasion and colonialism of Taiwan. If that sounds very aggressive to you, well, it's unfortunately an atrocious habit of China's. They currently directly control countries like Hong Kong and Tibet, and indirectly control several African countries. China has already expressed its desire to invade Taiwan. For this reason, Taiwan has strengthened its ties to powerful countries like the US. The reason Taiwan is so important is that it is the home of the Taiwan Semiconductor Manufacturing Company, better known as the TSMC. This is the world's best silicon semiconductor manufacturer, supporting a whole lot of firms, industries, and even countries. Other than invasion, another tactic China could use is to build its own silicon chip manufacturing company. However, this is very much easier said than done. The complexities of silicon manufacturing are numerous, and even a giant like China may lack the technical know-how. Taiwan even took years to get to the level they are, and much of their economy supports the silicon manufacturing industry. To help themselves in this regard, China could also consider poaching specialized talent from other countries. This is already happening even today. African and Asian countries have complained about brain drain from their locales to China. The brilliant individuals carry trade secrets along with them, accelerating China's development through the roof. There has even been one lawsuit about the matter. This happened when US-based microchip manufacturer Micron sued Chinese-associated UMC. U.S. is dependent on the Chinese user.